Hello, everyone. In this talk, I will show you how to automatically generate a GraphQL API based on your Prisma schema. I will be talking about the TypeGraphQL Prisma integration. Before we start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Michael. I'm a senior software developer, and I'm also a creator of the TypeGraphQL framework. You can find me on Gitter and Twitter using that handle on the bottom of the screen. So let's start with what is actually the TypeGraphQL. It's basically a tool that allows you to describe your GraphQL schema using TypeScript classes with decorators and introduce the GraphQL schema like the GraphQL schema SDL on the right based on the class recipe on the left. It not only produces the types, but also allows you to define your resolvers in a class-based fashion. So what is the TypeGraphQL Prisma? There's a few good answers to that question. It might be like a Prisma integration for TypeGraphQL. It's also a package that can be found on NPM registry. It's also a Prisma generator. So it hooks into the Prisma generate workflow. But the most broad answer to that question would be a tool that auto-generates a GraphQL API based on your Prisma schema. So if it's a Prisma generator, how do we actually can use that? The generator we always use is a Prisma client.js generator. We describe that using the generator block. So with the same syntax, we can create a describe the generator for the TypeGraphQL Prisma by providing the TypeGraphQL Prisma name under the provider key. We also have a control of the output. By default, it's a node modules, and it generates a transpiled JS files. But we can also point to our src folder. So it will generate, it will emit the TypeScript source file. So what actually the TypeGraphQL Prisma do? It reads the Prisma schema, like the user model on the left, with all the properties, all the types, and all the Prisma attributes, and generates TypeGraphQL classes based on that. It's putting the decorators, like the object type for the generated class, and also all the properties like ID, email, or name in this example are annotated with the field decorator with all the nullability settings and all the types provided. But it's not only this. It not only generates the model types like the user, but it also generates a bunch of stuff that are reflecting the capabilities of Prisma client. It also can generate args type that corresponds to the parameters of the Prisma client methods like find unique or find first. In this example, it's find unique user args. It also generates the input types like user when input, which corresponds to the nested properties of the find user args. We also have output types like user count aggregates, which corresponds to the data we return from the aggregate methods of the Prisma client. But the most important thing is that it also generates resolvers, two types of resolvers. The first one we see on the right is the CRUD resolver, which generates methods and queries and mutations. And that corresponds to the most popular CRUD operations like find first, find many, create, update, delete. But we also have relation resolvers. So for example, when single user can have multiple posts, we can easily generate the relation resolver, which automatically resolve the relation, fetch the data from the database. So we don't need to think about the relations and getting the nested data at all. So if we generate the resolvers, that the TypeGraphQL Prisma integration generates the resolvers, how can we then create the GraphQL API from them? So the integration generates a file which contains a resolvers export. So if we import the resolvers array from that file, all we need to do is to just provide it in the build schema function from TypeGraphQL package under the resolvers key to build a GraphQL schema, GraphQL executable schema. So in just two lines, we have the GraphQL executable schema. So all we need to do then is just to expose that to the HTTP, like using the Apollo server. We just need to provide the schema. And the most important part in this configuration is the context, because we need to provide the Prisma client instance inside the context, like we see on the right of the screen. So let's make a quick demo to show the capabilities of that generated GraphQL API. Here we have the really simple query that will get all the users with all the posts that the user create, with all the details like ID, email, and name. And if you execute that query, it will return our data with all the nested relations like post of the user and all the data we have described in our database. But it's not only capable of simple things, we can also provide some arguments that corresponds to the API of the Prisma client. Like, for example, we can filter users by email if it contains Prisma, and we also can order by the name of the user in descending order. And if we look at the post, we are defining that we only care about posts where title contains Prisma, and we only want to take the first one. And here we have the results. We get the users sorted by name, like here is first Bob, the second is Alice, and we only have one post with the Prisma in title. We can also have execute mutations like create. In this example, we can create a user and we get the data with the generated ID, and we jump back to the get all users and execute that again. It will be on the bottom without any post defined. And the generated GraphQL API has much more capabilities and much more is capable of executing much more complex queries. Like here we have a group by post exactly. And we are grouping by a published flag, by the published status. And we only care about posts when the author name contains Alice. So if we execute that query, we'll see that Alice have one post which is published and one post which is not published yet. But the GraphQL CRUD API in the fully-fledged GraphQL API is not the only possibility of using the TypeGraphQL Prisma integration. What if you want to expose only selected models or selected Prisma actions? This integration generates also separate resolvers classes, like user relation resolver for fetching the relations, user CRUD resolvers, or also there are resolvers for selected actions like find unique, find many, or aggregate. So all we need to do is to import that resolvers we're interested in, and then put them into the resolvers array of the build schema function. And if we expose a server with such schema, there will be no way to, for example, create a post like we saw in the demo. It is capable of. There are a few more features that are helpful in customization of our GraphQL API. For example, we can omit some model fields. Like on the left, we have the user model with the password field. And basically, we don't want to show our API users the password of selected user. So we have to be, it has to be defined on the Prisma schema level because it has to be stored in the database, but we don't want to show that into the outside world. So we use the TypeGraphQL omit attribute. It's actually a Prisma schema documentation comment because Prisma does not yet support custom attributes. So it's kind of workaround. And if we use the TypeGraphQL omit attribute, the password field won't be exposed to the outside world at all. We can also rename model types and rename the fields. For example, on the right, we have model user, which will be exposed under the client type name in our GraphQL API. And the balance field, balance column in the database will be exposed as an account balance field in our GraphQL API using the similar syntax as a custom attributes, but under the documentation comments. We can also expose custom resolvers. So we have some custom logic we want to have in our GraphQL API, and the TypeGraphQL Prisma integration does not limit us only to the generated CRUD API. We can have all custom domain logic. Like in this example on the left, we can see a best user query, which only gets the first user when email is natalia@prisma.io. It's a really simple logic, but allows to demonstrate the capabilities of custom user resolvers. So having that custom query user resolver class, we need to provide that into the resolvers array of the build schema function. And we can also extend the model by providing additional fields. To do that, we use the model, we create another resolver class, this time with the field resolver decorator. So on the right, we have the user favorite post field. And the implementation is really simple because it returns the first post of the selected user using the Prisma client from the context and just return it. And it's really nice. It's really nicely working with the TypeGraphQL Prisma because here we are referencing the user type, the user class, which is exactly the one generated by the TypeGraphQL Prisma integration. So we don't need to define that class again and use the decorators. It's all already ready to use. So to sum up, there are a few key things you should remember after this talk about the TypeGraphQL Prisma integrations. It's a Prisma generator, and that helps you automatically generate the TypeGraphQL classes, TypeGraphQL types, and all the CRUD resolvers for your Prisma schema model. It's really helpful for bootstrapping GraphQL API in just a few minutes, which is really great for prototyping and need to have something done in just a few minutes. But it's also configurable and customizable. So you can adjust that according to your needs and extend the capabilities if you want. So that's all. Thank you for your attention.
Michał, thank you for the talk and the in-depth walkthrough. And also, sorry if I mispronounced your name in the opening. I think it was really nice to see how the generated GraphQL API provides extensive filtering and sorting options all out of the box.
Yeah, that's really great. Thanks for having me.
You ready to take some questions?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get into it. And a quick reminder again that you can drop your questions in the Prisma Day channel. So we had the first question that we had was, so typically as you covered in the talk, GraphQL APIs backed by a database, obscure database fields from the API, for example, password hashes. And TypeGraphQL's approach to this is to explicitly omit fields by adding comments in the Prisma schema. And the question is there also a way with TypeGraphQL to explicitly include database fields rather than explicitly excluding?
Currently, there's only a mechanism to explicitly omit, hide a Prisma model field from exposing by GraphQL. However, from a technical point of view, it could be quite easily implemented, especially when the custom attributes will become available in the Prisma schema.
I see. We had a question from Aman from the audience, and perhaps you can chime in on this. And he asked, where can I get a starter type GraphQL Apollo server and Prisma starter? So do you have maybe an answer, or do you think you could share a link? I think we also might have an example.
Yeah, I think there are examples on the Prisma examples repo and also in the type GraphQL Prisma GitHub repo. There's also an example repository.
Okay, so Aman, rest assured, we'll be sure to drop a link. Now, does type GraphQL Prisma leverage the data loader in Prisma client to solve the N plus one problem?
Actually, type GraphQL Prisma was initially using the data loader directly at the beginning, but when the data loader was become built in the Prisma client, the type GraphQL Prisma now relies on that, and thanks to this mechanism, the generated relation resolvers allows for batching database requests by the Prisma client, so it solves the N plus one problem very well.
Oh, okay, I see. And in general, how do you think about maintaining backwards compatibility in the GraphQL API when the database schema changes? Do you have any sort of a high-level approach to this? How do you generally solve this issue?
Database migrations also need to be taken in a proper way, because in terms of GraphQL API, we can, for example, rename a field and deprecate the old one. But with database, we can only rename the column. We can't have duplicate values in the database. And with TypeGraphQL Prisma renaming fields capabilities, we can, for example, rename the column in the database by still exposing that under the previous name in the GraphQL schema.
This is
really complex problem, so it may be a bit hard to describe all the details in this quick question and answer section, because we are limited in time.
Yeah, sure. And how would this compare to something like Hazura, for example?
TypeGraphQL Prisma integration main focus isn't generating the fully-fledged GraphQL CRUD API. The main purpose of this integration was to generate all the code blocks like model classes, input and args type for TypeGraphQL, which can be then reused and composed in the custom resolvers written by the developers containing the domain logic, so that the developers don't have to manually write all the types corresponding to Prisma models and Prisma actions. So for now, it's not a competitor to Hazura. For example, it does not incorporate a really compatible pagination system. But even if that's not a main focus of this integration, the CRUD capabilities, the customization and extension options, I think they will be further developed in the future.
I see. On that note, Michał, I'd like to thank you once again for the talk and for sharing your experience and knowledge, and also for creating both TypeGraphQL and the TypeGraphQL Prisma generator. So I hope to see you soon at one of our meetups and events, and I'm wishing you an enjoyable rest of your day.
Thanks. Bye.
All right.